What do we want to start off with? Because there's so much to go through. We can talk Fabio Carvalho. If you want, we can get stuck into that. Well, the thing that I thought we could kick off with, actually, if you bear with me one sec, is a couple of things around centre-back. So our friend David in the chat there has just said as well, Pacho closing in on a move to Paris Saint-Germain. So we talked about Pacho on stage last night in Liverpool, and everybody was a little bit upbeat, including the people who were on stage. And then very quickly, it looks like PSG have moved and they're going to get that deal over the line if we don't act quickly. But it could well be too late at this point. In fact, it probably is. I'm sure we've seen the here we go from Fabrizio Romano earlier on when we were on the ferry. So what happens there? Well, Caught Offside have come out with a bit of a mad one. And I don't know if I believe it or not. But they say that Joachim Anderson is a potential target for Liverpool. Obviously, Crystal Palace defender, known to many of us Liverpool fans as the guy who wound up Darwin into getting that red card and getting sent off against Palace. But it is getting to squeaky bum time. It is, ladies and gentlemen. Let's be honest. There's only so much optimism a human being can have at this point. We need to get cracking. And all we seem to be hearing about is players we could be moving on. So the Fabio Carvalho stuff around Tyler Morton, stuff around Joe Gomez. Now, on Joe Gomez, it looks like Gomez wants to knuckle down and win a place under Arne Slot. And I love that. Every single person in Liverpool last night wanted to keep Joe Gomez. And I'm with them. Joe Gomez was such an integral part of our season last year that it would be madness to move him on when we're already short in other areas. So let me know where you guys want to go with this, because you know it's your stream, it's your show. On the centre-back position, speaking with David Lynch yesterday, he seems to believe that we're not going to bring in a centre-back who's going to come in and be a starter. It'll be somebody to come in to be third or fourth choice, a young centre-back with the view to them developing and growing, probably alongside Jarrell Kwanzaa, obviously Ibu as well. And that makes sense. I've got to say, I can understand that as long as it's the right centre-back. So, and a lot of us thought Willian Pacho was probably going to be that guy. 22 years of age, Ecuadorian international, but he's off to PSG. So that's another name we can tick off the list. Newcastle are in conversations with Crystal Palace for Mark Gay. Liverpool aren't interested in Mark Gay. We've also seen Bremer. Gelson Bremer signed a new contract at Juventus till 2029. That was earlier on. Juventus confirmed that on their own site. It said Juventus defender Gelson Bremer signed a new 5-year contract with the club. So that's another one out the window. We're running out of options that we're thinking of anyway as fans. So unless Michael Edwards has something big up his sleeve, it's getting concerning. Manchester City have just looked like they're about to sell Julian Alvarez to Atletico Madrid for 5 times what they paid for him 2 years ago. They paid about 14 million quid and it looks like they're about to sell him for 70. I told everybody, and look, to be fair, not just me, most of us knew when they signed him from River Plate, it was a bargain, the money they paid for him at 14 million. And now they're about to get 70 for a player who's unhappy and wants out. Also, Conor Gallagher. Again, he had a deadline from Atletico Madrid to accept the move from Chelsea. He accepted it with 1 minute left on the deadline. So everybody else is off doing stuff. I wake up every day and I'm seeing Chelsea signing somebody else. Todd Bowley interested in somebody else. United looking at somebody else. And we've still done sweet Fanny Adams. Nothing.